Hi guys, so in this section we will learn about protector 2. So what is protector? Protector is a combination of few technology like Selenium WebDriver, Jasmine Framework and Node.js. In combined, this tool is used to test AngularJS application. I'm telling AngularJS application, but we can test non-AngularJS application, but for non-AngularJS application, Selenium WebDriver is the best tool. Okay, but you can use AngularJS also. Okay, so we can test Angular application using Selenium WebDriver also, but there is a few advantage which we'll discuss before we install protector. Okay, so AngularJS has some extra element, like we use XPath, CSS, name, class, all these things using XPath. AngularJS introduced some extra element like ng-binding, ng-valid. So this we can find easily using protector. The best thing about protector is that is automated synchronization. Suppose you know about Selenium, so you have to put wait, like explicit wait, implicit wait to load the page, to click the element, all this thing. This thing is not required in protector. It is taken care by protector tool. This is the biggest advantage of protector. Okay, and as I told you, this can be test both AngularJS and non-AngularJS application. So what is AngularJS? I won't give much idea, but I give simple thing. AngularJS is developed to develop single page web applications. Okay, so the advantage of AngularJS is that when you are clicking some element on AngularJS application, whole page not get loaded. So I give you example while opening this website. Okay, it's opening. See, once this get loaded, you clicking, let it get refresh once, and I open Google also. Okay, so when you are clicking, this is Google is a non-angular, so when you are clicking anything, you see complete page get loaded. See, it get refresh again. Okay, you are clicking image or something. But when you go for AngularJS, once complete application is loaded, you clicking ebooks. See, its page is not refreshing. Only this certain section is get fetch data from backend. So it use limited resources. So this is the advantage of AngularJS. Okay. Now how to install AngularJS? So what you have to do? First you have to install Node.js. So to install Node.js, you go to this node.js.org site and download. So I'm doing on Windows, so you just do through Windows installer. Just click, it will download the Windows installer and then you can install Node.js. It's very easy. After that, what you have to do, once Node.js installed, you have to go to command prompt, go here and run this command. So I already installed, so it will install the protector tool, npm install -g protector. So it will install the protector. After that, you go and just run this command, web driver manager update. So what it does, it will get all the latest driver like Chrome driver and all these things, so Chrome and Firefox driver, so it will get updated. Okay, after that you have to start. So once you install, it will show the path where is your protector get installed. So you have to go user in app data, it will give a path when you're installing roaming npa. See, this is protector tool install like that. So when you install in command prompt only, just give the path where this protector get installed. So this is a web driver manager, this is protector tool, all this thing. These are different modules. Protector modules are get downloaded from website. Okay, so this is the way you can install. After get install, we have to restart the server. Okay, so to start the server, you have to run this command. So when you start, so the server gets started and it will, and on this local host it this get up. So you go and click here, so it will be, your hub will be like that. This is nothing but it will control the this. When you are running your test case, it will send the command from your local browser to the server to control the browser through using protector. Okay, so this way you need to install the thing. In next section, we will develop our test case in Eclipse. Thank you.